Hello, everybody, and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on
YouTube. Oh, my God, Tommy. He is the reason I am not doing my career.
Tommy Emo, everybody.
He made me retire from my career, and that's why, not his fan, you're over, bro.
He made you retire in what? Did you have 2 hours with the game at that point?
Yeah. I didn't even get out to NXT, and my last match was with Tommy Wong.
Back at playtesting, right?
Yeah.
Well, you're missing out here. I'm on SmackDown on the verge of going to Raw. It could be in this episode, actually.
This episode, we're possibly moving from Vicky to Triple H.
Well, I hope. It's been Vicky all along, so I don't know. Do we actually finally get orders from Triple H when we get to Raw?
I don't even know what my career is, so I'm just watching you now. And you said you always tune in the tune-up matches, right? Why do you tune?
Well, okay, so you get two choices. Basically, the dark match gives you more VC if that's what you need.
Okay.
I don't need VC because I've pretty much bought everything that there is to be bought in the game right now.
Yeah.
So I need social media followers because that's what gets you to the next show more quickly.
Okay.
So I always take that tune-up match. And now if you're in a pay-per-view month, when you know they come to you with a list of the pay-per-views. When you start off.
Did you just hit a finisher? A GTS. Dude, yeah. Is that it? Is Rusev done for?
Rusev is done. You know what? Rusev is my bitch in this game. He is not that great. I take him out.
A GTS.
Yeah,
from
that,
Max
that's
Smasher.
New, by the way. For those of you that have been following, I don't know why I just messed around and put the GTS in there for the finisher, or at least for one of the finishers. As he does have two, so he gets 23,000 followers there. And look at that, we're on the verge. 989,000 followers. We just need. What, like 11,000 more? Should be one more match.
And you're on SmackDown. You have more social media followers than most of the roster combined.
I know. Isn't that crazy that they make you get a million to get on Raw? Like, there's people on Raw that don't have close to that.
So I would pick dark match here. I would be going against Eric Rowan. Nope. Okay.
Well, you know, I kind of wanted that match against Eric Rowan, too, because we haven't had that. Okay, intro really quick.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Making his way to the ring, from Minneapolis, Minnesota, Matt Smasher. And approaching the ring, from San Francisco, California, weighing 228 pounds, Jay Uso.
So like I was saying before the intros, I would have liked that match against Eric Rowan. I went against... Who did I go against? Not Bray. Well, anyway, it's fun when somebody new comes on the list, but I hadn't fought either one of these, so I'm like, I'll take the Uso, seeing that it gives the social media. But in this case, I probably could have done either and still gotten to Raw.
So Max Smasher, is he kind of heelish? Because like, I'm watching you so far, and you go to the outside of the ring, you kind of play coy.
There was a big dilemma when we started. We were kind of right on the fence, and I was using managers that were face managers. By the way, why is Paul Heyman a face manager in this game?
Because Paul Heyman's the most over thing ever. It doesn't matter. Is Max Smasher here going up to the top? Ooh, what kind of moveset does he have?
He's got a poor moveset there because he missed completely.
Is it the moveset guy, or is it the guy that's back training Max Smasher in the back? Because I'm looking at the NXT trainer right now, and I'm a little worried about it. He's got the full heel tendencies, dude.
And if you look at his bar, it is completely to the right-hand red side for heel. So, you know, some people have said, well, maybe he should go back to face because... People loved my epic intro music as when he was a face. He had much colorful outfit and went to the kind of the dark side, I guess you could say here, and went full on heel. Because let's face it, I enjoy the heel tactics much more personally. That's just kind of me. But then some people have said, well, you know, make a face turn. But the thing I don't understand is the way this game is designed. I don't think you could ever do a like on a dime face turn because you'd have to work your bar all the way back slowly. Because, like, if I took this whole match and I didn't do anything, like slam him through a barricade or ring post or anything, I mean, it would go down, like, one little notch. back towards face.
So it takes quite a while. So you'd have to, like, you could either have to choose being face or heel on SmackDown, and then once you work your way up.
Yeah, and of course your decisions, you know, choose on who you get with feuds with. You know, I've had a feud with Daniel Bryan so far.
Already? Wow. Yeah. You went big.
It was awesome. And of course, I don't know. There's a couple people that comment around here that are like, that I apparently don't think I should ever lose a match, even though it builds drama and stuff.
No, it does.
Oh, there was. I know you and I have talked for eons about this, because I know you get that in your videos too. Why'd you lose, Tubby? You suck. You can't even beat that. Well, you were trying to set up a match. By the way, when I threw that chair in there,
you got the Roddy Strong knee, dude. You know who Roddy Strong is? You got, oh man, if you followed that up with a brain buster, that would be sick.
See, I should probably consult you with the moveset, because I probably do a lot of stuff that doesn't make a whole lot of sense. You see Jay kind of coming back on me here a little
bit. You got those straight punches. You got the Manny Pacquiao. 1-2-1-2, baby.
That's right, man. That's one of those things I bought, was like the combo punches. Like I said, I've stored up on everything. The only things that aren't equipped now are the ones that that like they can't work with another one already equipped. But I've bought everything outside of some of the managers. So, oh, come on, Jay.
What's your favorite feud been so far in my career? I'm looking at you right now as a heel. Is it Daniel Bryan? Who else have you gone up against?
I personally really popped for the Daniel Bryan. There was this... I just had a workup to SummerSlam, because SummerSlam has been my biggest pay-per-view so far. And they put me against Randy Orton, which didn't make a whole lot of sense. But other than that, he had the belt. But then...
Did you win the belt or did you lose the belt?
I lost the belt.
The chasing for the title is better than winning the title, in my opinion.
Well, also I've heard if you go for the WWE Championship and win it, I hear you're done in this mode, which scares me a little bit. I don't want to be done yet. But this was for the heavyweight championship. But by the way, Orton came to the ring with both belts. He defended my match, and then he went against Cena later on in the night for the WWE championship. I'm like, what's going on?
Oh, you got the package pile driver.
One of my fans calls that the smash compactor.
Oh, not a bad. That's actually a pretty good name.
I've been stealing all. I mean, this guy's comments. I should not be. I've read your comments over and over. I'm like some guy. I should be actually calling you by name, but. That's my bad for not knowing at this point. But
that wasn't your finisher? Like, I troll my audience.
That's my signature.
I call it a small package pile driver, and people just, like, get so pissed. I mean, like, Tubby, are you doing this on purpose? It's not a small package pile driver. I like your moveset. I'll be honest with you.
I'm pretty good with it. Now, people ask me, I'm not huge on the King of Swing, but, like, I do this because some people ask me to do this.
It's more of a face thing, like, because they love it.
Yeah, I don't know. He's a little conflicted. Like, see, that's it. I've got all the OMG moments, and they're all fun. But
they are.
I mean, I just kind of I try to vary up and give some variety as we go. But you know, I'm not gonna lie. My favorite things are smashing people through the announce table. I love going through the barricade, all that stuff. The OMG moment with the big boot to the ring or to the post.
Well, Max Smasher fits that gimmick right now. I like how you went when you said you're gonna go to the dark side. You actually did legitimately just make his clothes dark then.
Oh yeah, yeah. I've had fun with the gear. I mean, we started off with like SGU blue and orange, kind of, you know, my channel colors. I did a video on Christmas Day where I had him come out in red and green and a shirt that said ho 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 on it.
Oh, look at you go. You're planning ahead. You're making it work. You're more consistent with WWE than I am, and I'm a WWE guy. Oh, my God.
I know,
he goes
right?
Flying over the top.
I'm trying to go over in the WWE community.
You're going to be the best.
One of these days, I'm going to be invited out to SummerSlam or something.
Hey. Hey,
I'm not holding my breath, though.
Max Smasher is going to get invited out to places because Max Smasher's taking over the WWE.
That's right, man. So, I mean, you know, the people that say, you know, would you bring him back face? I mean, I wouldn't mind doing that, but I would love to see something implemented in this mode where there's like a split decision where you got to make a decision. Are you going to go heel? You know, I mean, because if you could surprise somebody with it and pull it off, that'd be awesome. I'd do that.
Another one on the outside.
That's right.
Are you going for a count-out victory? Like, what are you at it for a count?
You know, I did some of that early. I'm
Does that penalize you in the game? Does it have to be a decision?
No. Like, I got a draw, actually. I had two matches in a row against Luke Harper, and I had the sound off, and we had a draw, a double count-out, and then I had him the next time, and I beat him clean, but I'm like... It doesn't penalize you. You get less followers for it and stuff, though.
That's what I was
like,
talking about.
You'll have probably a four-star match instead of a five.
Okay, so
you know, something like along those lines.
But it makes sense then.
Yeah, certainly. So this match is actually not been too bad. It's not like...
No, Uso's putting up a little bit of a fight. I thought it was over when he hit the second package pile driver on the outside.
Now, one of the things... I can't remember if it asked me about difficulty in starting, and, you know, everybody knows I'm not the greatest at this game. I don't know the movesets.
He's not the greatest.
But that goes for any game I play. I play too many games to be good at anything. But, you know, it's like we play together, and you're like, oh, just do this. And I'm like, what?
What?
I'm like, I don't even know how to put him up on the... Like, right here, I should have put him up top, and I didn't even know how to do that until yesterday. What?
What?
But I'm learning as I go. I'm playing enough now to at least be a little bit dangerous. But
and then
here
the
we go with another GTS. Yeah, I don't know.
Max, I think if he had the knee brace on the other one, like... He's got the knee brace.
Oh, should I switch him around then?
The knee brace would be the thing that just kills him.
That would be legit.
GTS. So Max Masher's kind of legit, too. He looks pretty good.
Yeah. I was a little bit hesitant doing my career when you said, well, you know, it seems a little repetitive. And it is. Like, the you know, I don't know what it's going to be like when we get to Raw. But it's been a little more text-based than I wanted. I wanted a few more cutscenes out of things outside of the ring. That's the stuff I'd hope for. Moving forward with this mode, I hope they'll build on that, especially if they've got that relationship with the basketball brand, that they can do some of that, especially when you have all these unique superstars with their characters that they can do a lot of voiceovers and add that in. So that's what I'm hoping for. We've had just a little bit of it. I had one confrontation with Vicky backstage that was kind of cool. She wanted me to prove I could have 5-star matches, even though I had already been doing it, or 4-star matches.
You were already doing it because Max Masher is the most over dude in the world. I'm watching my career. Watches my career. The greatest of all time, according to that. And you, now headed to Raw. You are headed to Monday Night Raw.
Triple H, welcome to Raw. This is your chance to shine. You'll be facing the best in our business and competing for our industry's biggest prize, the WWE Championship. I think I threw an extra W in there. Grab that title and we'll talk about your legacy afterwards.
You've gotten up there faster than I have because I'm still down in NXT with Kevin Owens. What a bummer, but there he is.
So does this mean Triple H is going to like rebrand me and bury me now?
He's going to repackage you. He's going to send you back to NXT, a jobber. And
I'm
going to
come out as like a clown next week or something.
And if Randy's still the champion, you lost to him once. This is your shot to overcome. Can Max Masher make it and win the WWE Championship?
Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, go ahead and join the SGU team. Like the SGU Facebook page. Follow us on Twitter. Go ahead and subscribe to SGU here on YouTube so you don't miss daily videos. And last but not least, follow us on Twitch for live streaming goodness.